How can we make a GitHub Copilot to write code in our own style or the style of the project we are developing? I will show you what happens when I ask Copilot to define two very simple model classes. I tell it the request is coming. Then I list what I expect to have. Model a company with a name and an address. Model an address with street address, city, state, postal code and country. The last instruction specifies where to place them in the web model's namespace. I already know how I would type these classes. Let's see what Copilot has got for me. Some code is there. I already see a ton of issues. Why no file scoped namespace? Why do both classes look like DTOs? I don't remember asking for stupid DTOs. All properties mutable, not even initialized. I cannot believe this code was the AI's first choice. Well, that situation is about to change. This video begins now. You can feed Copilot with a whole bunch of instructions on how to behave in coding and design. Copilot has recently introduced instruction files. Choose the new instruction file command and specify your rules. Let me undo what it just made and then I will show you this feature in action. Copilot will offer to place the instructions file in the GitHub folder. That way you can commit the instructions and share them with the team that works on the project. Give the file a descriptive name, such as style guidelines. The instructions file starts with a file pattern to which it applies. I will match C# files. Then you can start writing individual instructions. This is a markdown file. Keep it structured to avoid conflicting instructions. You can organize related instructions into sections. There is only one namespace instruction I want to define. Use file scoped namespaces. This is what Copilot didn't do in the first attempt, which really annoyed me. Another complaint is about mutable classes. In this project specifically, I want to use immutable types as much as possible. Here is the instruction. Prefer immutable types unless mutability is requested. Prefer records over classes for immutable types. I noticed that Copilot created both classes in one file. Let's clarify that. Define one type per file. Even this simple set of instructions will impact how Copilot generates code. I'm saving this file, clearing the prompt, and running the last request again. This time it is indeed defining the record for the address. Another record models the company containing the address property. Let me explain what just happened. Copilot picks the content of all instruction files and includes it with every prompt. The instructions I just made have become a part of the prompt, directly affecting the output. Notably, Copilot will not use the instruction files in inline suggestions, only in chat prompts. Still, my work here is far from over. I will undo the generated code and refine the instructions. More instructions will define how Copilot should generate record types. The majority of the main models in this project will be in records. I want them to follow strict style guidelines. Define record properties on the same line as the record declaration. Records usually have only a couple of properties. Accompany each record with the appropriate static factory class. Place the factory class in the same file as the record. Expose a static create method in the factory class for instantiation. Place argument validation in the create method. This means everybody will instantiate records using the static factory method. Let's put that straight too. Never use a records constructor when there is a factory method. What about records that contain multiple objects? Use immutable collections in records unless requested otherwise. I would sometimes put an array in the record, but most often I would use immutable collections. Use immutable list of T in records whenever possible. Finally, define the records behavior in extension methods in other static classes. Let me save the instructions file and clear the chat one more time. I'm repeating the same prompt, and again I receive a completely different code. The record definition and the factory method have really been generated the way I requested. Let me check the company model. It follows the same design with one line defining the record and the static factory method in a separate class in the same file. I will accept these changes. You can extend the instructions to much more complicated cases if you like. Before I show you an advanced set of instructions that will also work like a charm, if you are enjoying what you are seeing here, please consider becoming a patron. This channel is free thanks to the patrons, to whom I am grateful. Patrons also have access to the source code of all the videos on the channel, as well as many other goodies not available on YouTube alone. I will now define the instructions for discriminated unions. Any mutable domain model will be swarming with discriminated unions. The C# language still does not support them natively, but we can easily work around that. Look at this. Prefer using records for discriminated unions. Derive specific types from a base abstract record. Define the entire discriminated union in one file. Define one static factory class per discriminated union. Expose one static factory method per variant. I can already imagine the code that satisfies these instructions, and I wonder if Copilot will see it the same way as I do. One more rule to bind them all. Follow all rules for record design when designing a discriminated union. This should be enough. I will save the instructions and start a new prompt, asking Copilot to define the model for invoices with invoice lines. That should be a more complicated example than the preceding one. An invoice consists of multiple lines. A line can be one of these: price, discount, tax, thin line, or a thick line. Some lines contain a decimal price, such as the price line, discount, and tax. The invoice contains a decimal total. The total is a value calculated from invoice lines. Implement these types in the web model's namespace. What shall it be? Copilot is generating code, and I already see that it has adhered to my requirements regarding discriminated union design. There is an abstract record for the invoice line, as well as one derived record for each of the variants. I see the factory methods for each of them. I see that only the price, discount, and tax lines contain the amount, just as requested. Each type has a factory method with validation that seems reasonable at first sight. Not quite as I wanted, the invoice record is located in the same file as the invoice line definition. Still, it has its own invoice factory static class with one factory method. Notably, the invoice lines are stored in an immutable list, just as I wanted. The total property is defined on the record, which I specifically told it not to do. But these nuances are small compared to the entire body of code it generated, which is generally aligned with the instructions I gave it. It would take only a minute to clean up this code and make it 100% aligned with the coding style I envisioned for this project. From this short experiment, you can see that the instruction files are quite useful when using GitHub Copilot. Instead of spending several minutes per class or methods, you can now accept most of the code it generates and only make a tiny correction here and there. On most occasions, the code will turn out precisely as you wanted it.